In the name of Allah, the Most Beneficent and the Most Merciful. I am your English teacher, Aisha Shahzad. I welcome you all to the online classes of Divisional Public School and Inter College, Sahiwal. In this lecture, we are going to discuss three different topics from the exercise of lesson number 6, the Qaeda's Vision and Pakistan. Our first task is to enhance our knowledge how to read a dictionary. Secondly, we will discuss what is denotation and what is connotation. Thirdly, our task is to identify the primary and secondary stress in certain words. As you know, we all need a dictionary whenever we have to find the pronunciation, meaning, synonym, antonym, or the origin of a particular word. You all have been using different dictionaries at home and school since your early schooling. I suggest that Oxford Advanced Learner's Dictionary is best for you at this level. When we open a dictionary, we see the words in bold letters. These are called the entry words. We can search any required word easily as they are arranged in alphabetic order. Next, you can see the pronunciation of each entry word given in phonetic symbols. Like, this is pronunciation of unwrap. This is pronunciation of unwritten. This is pronunciation of unyield. This is pronunciation of unzip. The pronunciation of each word is given in phonetic symbols, which help us to pronounce it precisely. The pronunciation is given in both British English and North American English. We have to follow the British accent only. It seems a bit difficult for you to understand the phonetic symbols at this stage because phonetic symbols need a lot of practice. We shall discuss them in another lecture. Our first step was to search the entry word, then we read its British pronunciation. After that, the dictionary gives you the further description about that word, whether this entry word was a noun, verb, adjective, or an adverb. Then come such abbreviations. SYN stands for synonym, which means that the dictionary can show you the words having similar meaning of the entry word. OPP stands for opposites, which means the dictionary can show you words having opposite meaning of the entry word. PREP. This abbreviation means that a word can convey a different meaning with different prepositions. Like, get me a glass of water means fetch me a glass of water. And get up early in the morning means rise early in the morning. So get and get up show different meanings. PP. This abbreviation means the past participle of the entry word if it is a verb. Like, got is the past participle of get. IDM. This abbreviation means that this word is also used in certain idioms. What is an idiom? Idiom is the artistic expression through words. For example, get over is an idiom, which means to overcome. Like, he got over his fear of thunder means he overcame his fear of thunder. Get through is another idiom, which means to complete or reach the end. For example, when we say he got through the examination successfully, it means that he has passed the examination successfully. So, you know that a dictionary can give you a vast variety of meanings. In our daily conversation, a word can have two types of meaning. First is denotative and second is connotative meaning. Do you have an idea about these terms, denotative and connotative? I guess these terms are new for you. Let me explain. Denotation is simply the dictionary definition of a word, and connotation is the secondary meaning of the word associated to your emotions. Denotation is the exact literal meaning of a word. You can see in this example, the family sat together in front of a warm fire. The denotative or literal interpretation of warm is nearly hot, which shows the actual temperature of the room. Connotation is the unspoken, hidden meaning that gives a word more emotional impact. We have the same example, the family sat together in front of a warm fire. Here the connotative or figurative interpretation of warm is comforting or friendly. Let's think of words as superheroes. They appear ordinary most of the time, but they have hidden powers. Like, you feel flattered when your mother says, "You are my tiger, you are my kitty." On the other hand, you feel embarrassed when your teacher says, "Hey, donkey, be attentive to this lesson." And you feel very angry when your friend calls you a monkey. Why did you feel different each time? What comes to your mind when you see this image? Dove. Peace, calmness, tranquility. What comes to your mind when you think of a star? An actor or actress? A singer? A cricketer? Or any celebrity? So these two words create a very positive feeling. but the word snake and fox create a very negative image. We get an idea that just like these words, adjectives can have three types of connotative meaning: positive connotation, negative connotation, and neutral connotation. Positive connotation means a word which creates a positive image. Negative connotation means a word which creates a negative image. And neutral connotation means it creates a neutral image, which is not positive and not negative. We have a slender boy here. If you say his body looks thin, it will be a neutral comment. If you say his body looks slim, it will be a positive compliment. If someone says his body looks skinny, it will be a criticism, which shows he has no muscles, just the skin and bones. Although thin, slim, and skinny all mean the same, but thin is neutral connotation, slim is a positive connotation, and skinny is a negative connotation. Positive and negative connotation of adjectives have the power to create an impression of approval or disapproval, appreciation or criticism, liking or disliking. Which word has a connotation of criticism? Lazy or relaxed? The word lazy shows a person to be careless and negligent, so it is a negative connotation. Which word has a more positive connotation? Cheap or thrifty? Thrifty means frugal, a person who spends money carefully. So, thrifty is a positive connotation. So, connotation refers to the wide range of positive and negative associations that are emotionally or socially connected with words. It is the emotional and imaginative association surrounding a word. Connotation represents the various social hints, cultural implications, or emotional meanings associated with a sign. Let's have an exercise. First of all, we have a word notorious. The denotative meaning or the dictionary meaning of notorious is well known. Famous is its positive connotation, and infamous is the negative connotation of notorious. Our next word is spinster. The dictionary meaning of spinster is unmarried. The positive connotation of spinster is a woman whose occupation is to spin. The negative connotation of spinster is a woman who is unlikely to marry. Our next word is stern. The denotative or dictionary meaning of stern is strict. The positive connotation of stern is firm or determined. The negative connotation of stern is harsh. Our next word is proud. The denotative meaning of proud is anyone who feels pride in something. The positive connotation of proud is satisfied and pleased. Arrogant is the negative connotation of proud. Shrewd. Shrewd means sharp in a dictionary. Its positive connotation is intelligent and its negative connotation is cunning or crafty. Next word is economical. The dictionary meaning of economical is the one who spends money carefully. Its positive connotation is frugal. Miser is the negative connotation of economical. Fail. The dictionary meaning of fail is to be unsuccessful. The positive connotation of fail is not good at doing something. The negative connotation of fail is to be defeated. The third topic in this lecture is syllables and stress. Let's take the example of banana. B-na-na. It has three syllables. First, you need to know what a syllable is. A unit of pronunciation having one vowel sound with or without surrounding consonants forming the whole or a part of a word. Be clear that each clearly pronounced vowel sound makes a syllable. We don't mean a vowel alphabet. We mean a vowel sound. When we pronounce a word, one syllable can produce more clear, louder or longer sound. As you can see in the word banana, banana, the other sounds are less clear. The sound in the center is pronounced more clearly. Such louder or clear syllable has a stress upon it, so it is called the stressed syllable, and the other one is called unstressed, which is pronounced softly and quickly. The louder syllable is the second syllable. So we can say that this is stressed syllable and it has a primary stress. First syllable is a little less in its loudness. Banana, banana. The second syllable has primary stress. First syllable has secondary stress as its level of loudness was at number 2. And the third syllable is pronounced very softly. So this is unstressed syllable. Let's have a few more examples. Our first example is unwritten. Unwritten. It has three syllables. Our first example is unwritten. It has three syllables. As you can see, the second syllable has a mark of stress upon it. This mark shows that this syllable has a primary stress. The mark of primary stress is here on the top at the beginning of the syllable, and this mark on the bottom at the beginning of the syllable shows that this syllable has a secondary stress. Our next example is unwrap. Unwrap has two syllables. The syllable wrap has primary stress upon it, as you can see. The symbol of primary stress on the top at the beginning of the second syllable. This mark shows secondary stress at the beginning of first syllable. Next example is Abraham. Abraham. It has three syllables, and you can see the primary stress is on first syllable. First syllable has the primary stress, second syllable is unstressed, and third syllable has secondary stress. Next example is president. President. It has three syllables. First syllable has primary stress upon it, as it is pronounced more clearly. Second syllable is unstressed, and the third syllable has a secondary stress upon it. Next example is teach. Here E and A make a long vowel sound, E, teach. It comprises of one syllable and it has only one stress, which is primary stress. Next week, our last example is ponder. It has two syllables, ponder. The first syllable has primary stress upon it, and the second syllable has a secondary stress. This mark shows secondary stress. Practice of syllables can help you to improve your pronunciation, but you can do this practice with audio dictionary. Let's review what you have learnt. First, your dictionary skills are polished. Secondly, you came to know the difference between denotation and connotation. Thirdly, what is positive and negative connotation? And fourthly, what are syllables and how are they marked as primary stress and secondary stress? I have a few assignments for you, which are going to be a great fun. Number one, describe your personality by using 5 positive connotations and 5 negative connotations. It is really interesting to know your personality. Assignment number 2 is solve exercise E at page 67. Assignment number 3 is solve exercise A at page 68 of your book. You have to solve assignment number 1 on your notebooks. Assignment number 2 and 3 are just to be solved on your books. It is a very simple activity, as we have already discussed these exercises in today's lecture. I hope you all have enjoyed the lecture. Thank you for being attentive. Allah Hafiz.